Hi, welcome to the Schoolhouse Test 6 video. For this video, I'm using the professional edition of the software. So one of the questions that we get often from new customers who are using the software is, how do you add questions when you're creating your test document? So let's see if we can do this quickly. I'm clicking on New to start a new blank test. So when you click New like this, it'll bring up the program in Design View. And of course, there'll be some defaults in Document View and in Answer Sheet View and in the Answer Sheet Zip Gray View and Solution View. You know, headers, footers, those sorts of things. And there'll be some pop-ups occasionally. You can turn those off. And but once you're in Design View, you're ready to add questions and or design items, of course, or organizational items. So any of these items that are in the item selection list can be added to your test document. Probably the most popular is multiple choice. And so to add my first multiple choice question, I simply come over here to the items selection panel and or pane and click on multiple choice. And what happens is the first multiple choice blank question is brought in. Now, for this video, I'm not going to go into a lot of detail about what all these fields are. You can take a look if you want a little information about some of these things. If you hover over these little light bulbs, you'll get some information. But I just want to show you, so this is my first question. So, why did the chicken cross the road? And I'm just going to put some nonsense answers in here just so that I can quickly add some information so that we can move on to the next one, and we'll say number 3 is the correct one. So there's my first question, my first multiple choice question. If I come into the document view, this is your test document, you'll see that this is the first question here. Now there's all sorts of settings over here in document options. For color, marks, check marks, bubbles, that's what these things are. There's so many things in here, spacing, whether you want it 2 columns or 1 column. But I just wanted to show you that this is where your questions will show up. This is your test document. Okay, back into Design View. Now I've got my first multiple choice question in here. What do I do if I want to add a second blank multiple choice question? Well, I can click here on multiple choice again. It'll just take a little bit. There we go. So here's my, so I'm coming over here to design layout, which is where all of your questions and design items and organization items will appear. And you'll see if I click here on the first one, that that's the first one that I added. And now I have this blank second question. Let's see, why did the cat chase the chicken? And again, I'm just going to put some nonsense answers in here just so I can quickly show you. And we'll say number 5 is the right answer up there. So we've got 1 multiple choice question, 2 multiple choice questions. And again, if I wanted to add yet another multiple choice question, I could click here again in the item selection pane, or, and this is new to Schoolhouse Test 6, we have a new feature here called Repeat Add Item. So if I click here, it says repeat the addition of the currently selected item. So the currently selected item over here is multiple choice. So if I click here, I should get a new blank multiple choice question, and I do. So let's do that again. So multiple choice is highlighted, and if I click here again, I'm going to get another blank multiple choice question. Okay, so I'm not going to add more of these. I'm going to get rid of these blank ones. I don't really need them. So I don't want to save test. Nope, not right now. So when this is highlighted, if I come up here and click remove, it will remove that question. Okay, so I've got two multiple choice questions. Let's say now I want a short answer question. What do? I come over to item selection and I click on short answer. And it brings this up. Why did the walrus sit on the car? And then an answer. All right, again, more nonsense. So I get a short answer one, and if I wanted to repeat that, I could come up here and click. Of course, I could just click here on short answer, and I would get another blank short answer, as I see over here, or I could click here and get another blank short answer. And that applies to all of these things. Let's say after I've got all these short answer here, maybe I want to add a divider line. And I've got a divider line here. I could just click repeat and it would add another divider line. And for those of you that really use the keyboard a lot, there's a keyboard shortcut, Control Shift plus R. So you can see fairly quickly, you can add new questions to your test document, and you can do that either by clicking on a question item here in item selection, like checklist, or if once you've got something highlighted over here, you can click on the repeat add item button, which is a new feature to Schoolhouse Test 6. So I hope this is helpful. I've been working with Schoolhouse Test 6, the professional edition. Thanks for viewing our video, and do visit our YouTube channel to see other videos from Schoolhouse Test 5 and from Schoolhouse Test 6. Both of them are very close in terms of functionality and features that they have. So if you're new to Schoolhouse Test, you can view either Schoolhouse Test 5 video or Schoolhouse Test 6. Thanks very much.